confident at Jarrett.
Well, Neil Bonnick, he got into the Axiom and had no problem in getting that window screen unfastened. He gets his driving gloves off now. He already has the safety belt and the shoulder harness unfastened. Now his helmet comes off. Of course, being in victory lane here at the Daytona International Speedway twice within the last 4 days. Significant amount of money, $50,000 in the Busch Clash, and now $18,000 here today. He waves to the crowd and gets a big handshake.
Give him a big wave.
Big hand from the folks here in Victor Lane. Neil, congratulations.
Ned, I tell you what, these boys, Barbara Hilly, Butch Mott, and Jake Elder, Warner Hodge and them put out some effort with this race car, and it's showing up right now. The car just runs super. I was sitting there leading the race. I knew I couldn't win the race in the lead, so I had to back the whole pace. I had to slow the whole line of cars down. I saw Richard coming. I felt like that's the man I need to be following because he's going to the front.
Well, you got that thing down pat now, that last lap deal.
Well, I'm going to try one from the front next time. I believe this thing will do it from the front, but I just wanted to be careful.
Well, Neil, these Chevrolets with that slope front end on it, apparently they're handling well, better than you expected maybe when you came to Daytona.
Neil, I tell you what, the Chevrolet people did one heck of a job with this race car, but I'm a little loose in the corner right now. When I was leading the race there, I was a little bit loose. We're going to have to do a little bit more work. You know, the crew hasn't stopped working on the car since we've been here, and we won two of the races, so we're going to keep working and get the thing ready for the 500.
Well, here's a young lady that's very happy, his wife Susan, in the Victor Lane, and the traditional kiss from the wife Susan. I know that you're very happy too.
Yes, I am.
Well, Tim, that's the happy scene here in Victor Lane.
Let's go to more unhappy news for the moment. Let's see what we can get for a report from the field hospital here at Daytona. Larry Neuber standing by.
Well, Ken, the news is good. I'm standing with James Hilton, of course, another one of the drivers who competed here this afternoon. James just came out of the hospital, and the report on Rusty is pretty positive right now, isn't it?
Well, I'm not a doctor. I don't claim to be, but I happened to be in there when they brought Rusty in. And all his vital signs are good. The doctors talked to us about it, and the two brothers who are in there have already talked to Rusty. And, you know, he's got some injuries, but he's going to make it, and everything's good, and they're just taking him for a checkup. And they said he'll be released pretty soon, and he's not really that hurt.
We don't really have an update officially on Bruce Jacoby. The information that we do have is that apparently there are definite internal injuries. He is still in the intensive care unit. And as Ken Squire mentioned earlier on this broadcast, he is listed officially in critical condition.